This video is recorded with separate channels for audio and my voice. So hopefully everyone is happy with the sound quality now. I put on a de-esser at the end, I put on a limiter at the end, and hopefully everything will turn out right. So give me critics or some feedback in the comments. But let's start with this video. Today I want to show you how you can set up and sound to be evolve easily with just one macro knob. You know, when you create tracks, you want to have your sounds to evolve in some kind of way. And to do this, you have to use a lot of automation lanes. So multiple parameters, you need multiple lanes, and then you need to draw in all the stuff. But most of the times I start with a macro knob only. And I show you what I do and how I do it, because it's a nice workflow, I think, and I use it all the time. So when we have some kind of instrument here, I use phase 4. And let's draw in a note clip. And some notes. Maybe let's go with the bass sound, because I just released the Neuroprix package. So I'm creating some bass sounds here. And in the phase 4 front panel here, you can show the macro, the modulator section. And then we add some, or one macro knob at least, from 0% to 100%. And now we draw in or modulate all the parameters we want to change. So for instance, we have here an initial sound. Let's tune this a bit. So just a sine wave, basically. So now dial in some parameters with the macro knob. And for this, I turn this all the way up to 100%. So instead of turning the knobs and change my sound, I draw in just automations until it sounds right. So maybe this is not the best way, so we have to change this in before. Okay. So now we have a knob here, which we call intensity. And we can use this macro knob to just draw in some automation here. And with just one macro knob and one automation lane, we can have a sound evolve easily with the time. And now with your pattern drawn in into the clip here, we can just go in here and change some parameters to change the sound. Okay, so maybe we add just some effects at the end. Let's add an EQ. And maybe an amp device. So now we can activate the macro knob again and change some settings here. Maybe raise the high band. maybe add the reverb, and we change the initial settings for the reverb to be pretty small. Go to the macro knob, and now we change some settings. And now we can change the pattern or the rhythm of this modulation pretty easily because we have only one automation lane. And as you can see, with just one note and one modulation lane, one macro knob, you can create some kind of riff or, yeah, an evolving sound that sounds much more than just one note and one modulation. So this is an easy workflow to start when you don't know where it's going with your sound and when with your tracks. So when I do drum bass sounds, I do this all the time because it's so easy to have just one macro knob and then use the handle here and modulate different stuff inside the instrument to create an interesting, evolving and easy to change sound. And yeah, this is something I wanted to share with you. And you can also apply this to different sounds. Don't need to be a neuro bass sound. It can be also pad sounds or step sounds, etc. So when we go here with the poly synth, maybe can duplicate this so we have multiple. Okay, so let's add a pad sound here. So we add the macro knob like we did before, and now we change some settings so we have a nice initial sound. Maybe add an EQ to cut the low end. We add some reverb here. I'll just drag this into the FX box here. Let's add some delay. Okay. And now we start to change the sound. And now we can start to paint our story. And as you can see, I just started with simple notes. They're basically just the note F, the note C, and we have also just the note F, and just some modulations, and you can get an interesting sound out of the initial sound just by adding lots of modulations. And I already showed some stuff on Instagram where I have a lot of modulations going on, but this is an easy way to start, where you have just one lane, as I said, one modulation, and then you apply multiple modulations to this intensity macro knob and get much more as a result. Yeah, we can also apply this to step sounds, of course. So let's add another polysynth. So also just an F sound. Okay. We add in one macro knob and open up some modulations. Reverb, and we use a small space here because I like it. Add some delay and also some small delay times. And yeah, maybe also add an EQ, cut the low end. And change here something. Now we can morph basically between two states and get all the states in between as an, yeah, as a benefit. So let's add an modulation lane here, intensity, and draw in some stuff. All you need now is maybe a bass drum. Make this pretty short, so we have to draw all, also just one note here. maybe add this to a group, and in this group to use a tool and the sidechain, modulate the amplitude, use the kick drum as an input. Okay, so in this way you can create interesting patterns with just easy modulations, one macro knob, modulating multiple parameters inside instruments. Easy, straightforward, easy to change, and yeah, and it doesn't get too convoluted in the end. So that's a small workflow tip from me to you. And yeah, give me feedback on that. If you use this inside different DAWs, is it possible in different DAWs in Cubase, in Ableton? I don't know. In Bitwig Studio, it's easy as fuck. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.